Gene Okerlund here on location at the Temple of Ching Lao with Rick the Dragon Steamboat. Ricky Steamboat, it is right here on these premises where you and others have gone through and will go through intense training in preparation for not only professional wrestling, but for life itself. Let's journey through the Temple of Ching Lao for the three true tests of Ricky Steamboat.
Hey guys, welcome to This Week in History. Kathy Kelly here, joined by Corey Graves. And we are taking it back to September 10th, 1985. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat battling so many ninjas and finally earning his black belt.
Listen, if you plan on someday becoming a WWE Hall of Famer, capturing the Intercontinental Championship, one of the greatest matches of all time, okay? I mean, what better training is there than doing battle with ninjas?
That's very true. Mental preparedness, physical preparedness, but also the awareness of the martial art weapons. This is what the monks wanted.
Well, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat really earned that moniker, blowing fire, facing Mr. Fuji in the Kung Fu Challenge. There were so many times when he just proved what a ninja he was.
Well, and he's not the only superstar to have dabbled in the dark arts of the ninja. I mean, everyone wants to be a ninja.
Do you want to be a ninja?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know who else wanted to be a ninja?
Who?
Glacier. He was the best ninja of all time. WCW, it snowed when he came to the ring. He did the cryonic kick and not much else. So thankfully there were better ninjas, like actual, maybe not ninjas, but martial artists. Ernest the Cat Miller, superstar Billy Graham at one point became a kung fu master.
Well, I guess I'll open it up to you guys. Who is your favorite martial artist in sports entertainment history? Use the hashtag WWE History on social media, and we will see you again next week.